गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक। दिस वीडियो इज फॉर क्लास सेवेंथ सब्जेक्ट सोशल साइंस। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट ज्योग्राफी चैप्टर 3, आर चेंजिंग अर्थ। इट इज द फर्स्ट लेक्चर ऑफ दिस चैप्टर एंड इन टुडेज लेक्चर द टॉपिक्स विच आर टू बी डिस्कस्ड आर लाइक दिस। फर्स्ट, अर्थ्स मूवमेंट्स। सेकेंड, एंडोजेनिक फोर्सेज। थर्ड, एक्सोजेनिक फोर्सेज। And fourth one, sudden forces like volcano. In this chapter, we are basically dealing with lithosphere. Yes, friends, as we know that lithosphere is the solid crust or hard topmost layer of the earth, which is made up of minerals and rocks. About lithosphere, you have studied in your previous lecture also, that our earth is made up of different layers, and the topmost layer of the earth, which is hard, which is made up of rocks and minerals, is known as lithosphere. So these rocks or minerals, or you can say the top layer of the earth, are broken down into a number of plates, and these plates are known as lithospheric plates. And the earth's crust consists of different, or you can say means large and small, rigged, irregular shaped plates, which are also known as slabs. And these slabs or these plates carry down continents and oceanic floors, which are known as lithospheric plates. Yes, friends, here I have shown you one pic. Look in this picture, there you will see a black boundary line. Yes, this actually our whole earth is divided into seven big masses, and or you can say seven big plates, and these plates are known as lithospheric plates. And here this black boundary is shown as the lithospheric boundaries. Understood? And total there are seven lithospheric plates. Seven boundaries are there, means the earth, whole earth is divided into seven big masses, and they are surrounded by a means boundary, which is known as lithospheric boundaries. And these plates are like, first is the Indo-Australian plate, second the African plate, third one the Pacific plate, fourth the Eurasian plate, fifth the North American plate, sixth the South American plate, and seventh the Antarctic plate. So understood, students? So total these seven plates are there, and these lithospheric plates move around very slowly, just a few millimeter every year. And what is the reason behind it? Actually, the reason behind the movement of this lithospheric plate is molten magma. Yes, as we have studied that the earth is made up of different three layers. First is that is the crust, which is also known as lithosphere, and second one is their mantle, and third one is core. And as we know this also, that in the core, or in the core layer, that rocks are or minerals are found in molten form, which is known as magma. And this molten magma, that it moves in circular manners, and due to this movement of this magma, the lithospheric plates also moved. Means there is the movement in the lithospheric plate. So what is the reason behind the movement in lithospheric plate? The movement of magma. Due to the movement of the magma, lithospheric plates also move around. Understood? And there are two types of earth movement. These are endogenic forces and exogenic forces. Yes, students, endogenic forces or exogenic forces, actually endogenic forces mean the forces which act inside the earth, and exogenic forces the forces or the activities which act on or above the earth surface, means on the outer part. And this endogenic forces, it includes two types of forces. First is sudden forces, and second is diastrophic forces, means slow forces. So two types of forces of the endogenic forces, sudden and slow. And the sudden forces, it results earthquake, volcano and landslide. and dystrophic are the slow forces that it results formation of or building of mountains. Exogenic forces includes erosional and depositional activities, and the agents of this erosional and depositional activities are rivers, wind, sea waves and glaciers. So understood students, now we will have a look on the this earth movements and these two types of forces. Yes, first is endogenic forces. Yes, literal meaning means endogenic literal meaning is endo. It is made up of two word, endo and genic. Endo means inside and genic means origin, means the activities, the forces which act or originated inside the earth. And endogenic forces sometimes produce sudden movement and at the other times produce slow movement. Means endogenic forces has two type of movement, sudden and slow. Sudden movement, slow movement. And sudden movement which results earthquake and volcanoes. So these activities means like earthquake and volcano, they cause mass destruction over the surface of the earth. So understood about the endogenic forces? Yes, endogenic forces are the forces that originate inside the earth, therefore they are also called internal forces, and these internal forces lead to vertical and horizontal movements and results in land upliftment, volcanism, faulting, folding and earthquakes activities. And these endogenic forces are land building forces, and they that's why they play an important role in the formation of the earth crust, especially in formation of mountains. Yes, these are also called internal forces as they form, originate and are located below the surface of the earth. So students, understood about endogenic forces. Now is classification of endogenic forces. As I have told you that endogenic forces is divided into two movements, slow movement and sudden movement. Yes, slow movement means these are referred to as dystrophic forces and it results in changes over a period of time. And sudden movement, these are the, as the name referred or as the name suggests, that these are visible movements and include significant landform changes like earthquakes and volcanic eruptions. So understood, means slow movement, in simple term if we say that dystrophic forces can be defined as the forces that are created due to the movement of the solid material on the earth's surface, and this includes all the processes that raise, move or build up the parts of the earth's surface. Understood students about the slow movement? Yes. Next one is exogenic forces. As I told that exogenic forces means the forces which act or occur on or above the earth's surface, and exogenic forces which always lead to slow movement, and it includes the depositional activities. Understood? Yes. Now the example of endogenic forces: volcanoes and earthquakes. Yes friends, volcanoes, many times you have heard about it, volcanoes. So what do you know about the volcano? Yes, volcano, actually volcano is an opening in the earth's crust through which molten materials such as ash and hot gases are thrown out, and this happen due to internal pressure which pushes the molten material inside the earth called magma to the surface through an opening, and this opening is called vent, and this complete process is called volcanic eruption. Understood students? And the erupted molten material or lava gradually piles up and cools layer after layer over the years to form a cone shaped mountain, and which is called volcanic mountain. And sometimes volcanic eruption are slow, and when the magma oozes out gently through fissures and spreads over a large area forming volcanic plateaus, and such lava plateaus are rich in minerals and make the soil fertile. For example, India's Deccan Plateau. Yeah, so it is very fertile for growing cotton, and it is the result of volcanic eruption activities. So understood? Given in volcanic eruption activities, when magma cools down gradually, quickly, that it results the formation of mountains, and when it cools down slowly, then it results the formation of plateaus. Understood, friends? Yes. If you look at the cross section of a typical volcano, you will notice the various parts. These various parts are like this: magma chamber, vent, crater, and lava flows. Yes, magma chamber. It that is a large underground pool of molten rock below the crust. Means like a pond in which magma, molten magma is found, and it is found below the earth crust. Vent, the opening through which magma comes out on the earth surface. So this opening is known as vent. Crater, a ball-shaped depression at the mouth of the volcano through which ashes, different gases are thrown out. Lava flows, a mass of flowing or molten lava. Yes, now I have shown you the diagram of volcanic eruption activities. Yes, friends, look at the diagram. Look at the bottom. In the bottom, at the bottom, you will see that there is magma chamber. Means there is a great pool, great deposit of molten magma. And due to the heat and pressure, okay, this molten magma comes out and reaches on the earth surface through the cracks. And these cracks or the opening of the volcanoes, these are known as vent. Understood? And at the top, means where there is the opening, or you can say mouth of the volcano, at the top part, that is known as crater. And through this crater, with this molten magma, the other materials like gases and ash also thrown up. Understood, friends? So this is volcanic eruption activity. And the volcanoes are very important also. Like the material thrown out of volcanoes form fertile soil. They bring out useful minerals from the interior of the earth. They help scientists to understand the nature of the interior of the earth. And they are also tourist attractions all over the world. So in this way, these volcanoes are useful to us. Next activity, or you can say next force is there, that is earthquake. Yes, friends. What do you mean by the earthquakes? Actually, earthquakes are vibrations and felt on the surface of the earth. And these vibrations are caused due to disturbances beneath or below the crust. These disturbances could either be due to plates colliding or rubbing against each other, or due to volcanic eruption activities. Means when I told you about the seven plates, and when these plates, when they collide to each other, and so in this way, one shaking or vibration is felt on the surface of the earth, which is known as earthquake. Understood? And the point inside the earth from where the earthquake originates, it is called focus. Yes, here the two mean, you can say, the points of the earthquake, that is focus, and second one is epicenter. So what is focus? Actually, focus is the point inside the earth from where the earthquake begins or originates. And epicenter, the point exactly above the focus on the earth's surface is called epicenter. And the maximum destruction from an earthquake takes place at the epicenter. Understood, friends? Now I will show you the diagram. Look in the diagram. At the bottom of the diagram, one arrow is given, and here one place dot is shown, and this dot show the focus point. Means this is the point where the earthquake occurs, and just above this point, means above the focus, one another point is there, that is epicenter. Yes, friends, and the vibration produced during an earthquake, these are also called seismic waves. And the seismic waves means whose intensity reduces as they move away from the epicenter. Understood? So in this way, our today's lecture is completed. In tomorrow lecture, we will study more about earthquake, that earthquake measurements and safety measures and the land formations. Understood? Yes. Now note down your homework. Today's homework is there. Means you have to write the answers of these following questions in your FAIR notebook, and in which first question is there, that is of your NCERT textbook question. This is the first part of the first question, why do the plates move? And the second part of this question is there, what are exogenic and endogenic forces? This is also NCERT question. Third one is there, what do you know about the lithospheric plates? Understood? This I told you. And define focus and epicenter point in the earthquake. And question number fifth, how do the lithospheric plates move? Okay, students. So in this way, our today's discussion or lecture is completed. Tomorrow we will meet again with the next lecture of this chapter. Thank you.